Gluteal tendinopathy is the most prevalent lower limb tendinopathy. Keep on listening if you want to hear a quick pathology overview. Gluteal tendinopathy, or greater trochanteric pain syndrome, is characterized by tenderness laterally over the greater trochanter, and pain may radiate over the lateral thigh. It is most prevalent in women aged over 40 years, with some studies even reporting that about a quarter suffers from it between 50 and 79 years old. Earlier, we thought that the inflamed bursa at the trochanter was the key driver, but recent studies refuted this. The main idea behind this pathology is a loss of homeostasis in anabolic and catabolic processes. The tendon experiences too much load to recover. This load can be both tensile and compressive. Compression in this tendon can occur from excessive hip adduction during static or dynamic tasks. Examples are leaning on one hip, sitting with crossed legs, running with a midline cross or pelvic drop, etc. The key question is, how do we define excessive? People with gluteal tendinopathy may experience difficulty in rising after periods of sitting. A current hypothesis is that in over 90 degrees of hip flexion, the tension within the iliotibial band increases, pushing into the gluteal tendons. This could explain why pain might be worse when sitting in a low chair or a deep couch. Note that not every patient presenting with lateral hip pain has gluteal tendinopathy. Pain can be referred from different sources, such as the lumbar spine and the hip joint. So how does this condition present? As I mentioned, pain and tenderness over the greater trochanter that may radiate toward the thigh. Pain is often worse at night and affecting sleep quality. Patients will report problems with rising or walking after sitting. Patients with HIPOA, however, typically have difficulty putting their socks and shoes on, which is not an issue in gluteal tendinopathy. Spears et al. In 2017 published a useful flowchart guide for differential diagnoses seen here. This review discussed a lot of clinical tests with possible utility. Gannerton et al. In 2017 recommended the following: the Patrick's or Faber's test, palpation of the greater trochanter, resisted hip abduction, and resisted external derotation test have the highest diagnostic test accuracy for gluteal tendinopathy. Evidence on the best management is elusive. Most studies compare multiple modalities, making it hard to tease out specific effects. Potential options are advice and education, exercises, shockwave therapy, surgery, and corticosteroid injections. A review by Pianca et al. In 2021 looked at management for this condition. I know many physical therapists might not like to hear this, but corticosteroid injections seem to have some added benefits when combined with exercise intervention and/or activity modification in the short term. However, effects might not last long, as one study reported no differences after 1 year. Looking at shockwave therapy, the same short-term effects are found, but they might last longer than corticosteroid injections. Furthermore, the lead trial showed that activity modification and exercise might be superior to a standalone steroid injection. 79% of patients in the exercise group reported global improvements at 1 year. Clearly, future large and robust studies are needed to provide a clearer picture. That's it for this video. I hope you learned something today. I'm Max for Physiotutors, and I will see you in another video. Bye.